Anyway, so I want to talk about Linux. Do you really want a Linux system? No, Linux is a. You find it's like a babysitter, a job. You have to babysit it. You have to be there, update it, take everything fresh, brand new, and just believe and trust that it's going to be good for your system. And you have to be continual at it as a system administrator of your own little completely cutesy computer. So it's not always what you had cracked up to think it was about. And yet, after a while, it does become your own little adoration society, but yet I love it because it is kind of my own authorizations, my own mistakes. And if I blow the computer up by accident with the wrong directions, the wrong canonical, the wrong repository information, the wrong I just used the wrong program and the whole thing just went yagi, and I have to reinstall. It's really my doing, you know, it's my doing. And so in a way it does is like, well, it's like taking these viral things, and for a change in life you are the one responsible for the obtainance, rather than like with Windows, how it is the flow out, and you have no way of knowing. It's just like all of a sudden there. I'm not saying it's devoid of problems, because I have many problems with the screen having actions, with Java. Any kind of JavaScript likes to take over, so it has a takeover Java problem. So it's not great. It's not superior to being the perfect computer. Like, remember the old days? We didn't have any of this garbage. Yeah, the old days, a computer was there. There was a screen, and it did not come with all this eclectia, all of this cookie grabber, JavaScript hatreds, anything that would harvest your processor time. And now that's what we're looking at. We're looking at just like trying to control something that does not overtake, you know, so you keep up some kind of speed. Otherwise you just end up like, forget it, I just throw everything out and start over with a brand new fresh install. Now, with starting with a brand new fresh install, that means be prepared and not don't keep happiness only your life, everything on the computer. It has to be freshly, what do we call it? You have to put those little USBs in. You have to keep all of your files on the USB. You have to keep them on the Flickr. You have to keep them on photo bucket sites. You have to keep everything elsewhere, external, and just do not depend on your system being there. So in a way, it's just like, well, it's an operating system, but in the same token, you have to expect it to fail. You have to expect it to fail. But it's a different type of fail, because like with Windows, so often it's just like, oh, you got the blue screen of death, and you cannot reinstall, and you have to buy the brand new installation procedure certifications or whatever, and it costs a lot of money. So when any of that stuff is going on, you don't have to do that with Linux. So Linux does have it. One great is that you can have your free installation. So because you have your free installation, you can take over what was a Windows system then ruined, and so you can bring your computer back up from the dead. And so if you're trying to restore your computer up from the dead again, instead of throwing away something that was brand new, it is wonderful. It's a wonderful device. However, with it, you have to learn the operating system a little, and you do have to dig in there and do commands on the screen, on the command line prompt. And for many people, that is just not ever going to happen. So don't think that you can just switch from Windows to Linux and have a happy day. Many people cannot handle it. They just cannot handle it. Expect the fact that you would have had to have some kind of experience typing and writing commands. Because any time, even the commands that they're shown out here on the internet, you can be given incorrect commands that will devastate your whole system. So it is not full of, for the, what do we call them, the full hearties? No. It is you take it as a grain of salt. Every installation will be gone tomorrow, possibly. However, in the same token, you can always bring your computer back up from the dead. So that is the bonus. That is the bonus of Linux. And so we have to applaud it, that it does have that skill. Whether you have to go into the BIOS to restore it, where you whether you have to go into another installation, a side-by-side install or a triple install, just to try to get back to your files. That becomes the problem. It's always better to keep your files just away from it, or whatever files you're working on. Just don't fear or get sad if you lose them. That's all. So what? You lost them. So we get used to stuff. And there goes the other files again. I just lost all those things I wrote. So you don't get clingy with it. Yeah, a lot of people have these clingy problems with computer files. And yeah, we just gotta part with them and start over, you know, start over, brand new. So that's my Linux advice today. Is it's a cool system because it can bring them back. However, it's not really something that you can trust, that it is there as an endurance with your files. But the same applies to gosh dang it, the same thing applies to Windows. And Windows is almost worse because it lures you in and you're like, oh, I've been here so long and everything is so great and it's just like, and I've got my everything so pretty, and you know, it's just a beautiful graphical experience, and then blah. Oh my gosh, I just lost everything, you know, years and years of work. You know, you don't want to be in that situation, you know, because it's just like, it's not worth it. It's not worth it for your heart. It's not worth it for your health. So yeah. Computer. Oh, you can be mean to us health-wise, can't you? Gosh dang it. Yeah, so we have to just, you know, if you have photos, this has been my learn, it's just send them straight out to Flickr or send them straight out to the photo bucket. Just get them out there and don't keep them, you know, on your own little system. Just get them out there because they're safe. They're safe on those servers, you know, those servers. Yeah, it's tough and rough to run your own system, that's all. Yay, Linux.